tenure with law enforcement, as I said, is about service. The policemen aren't bad guys. You know, a lot of times kids are like, that's the police, we don't tell them nothing. But we're here to help you, so if you don't tell us anything, then we can't help you. We need you to help your community, and that's very important. It's not always about writing tickets and pulling people over on Sunday to tell them they're driving too fast. It's about helping people. It may be finding a lost kid. It may be talking to an old person late in the night who's feeling kind of lonely.
Somebody from the woman in purse.
Stealing a woman's purse?
Okay.
Yeah, and getting their purse back. Yeah, so you have to go get their purse back. That's important. You spend the time necessary to find the purse. If a purse gets stolen, she may have her rent payment in there. So you may have to go look for the guy that took it before he gets down the street and takes the money. So that's service. You're right about that. Well, to be a police officer, you have to be 21. But you kids, you got a chance to get to be 21. And when you're 21, you go to the police, you can sign up, go to the police academy. That's about 15 weeks of exercising, running about a mile and a half every day, doing a lot of book work. It requires a lot of book work because you have to know the laws about arresting people and laws about traffic. So it requires you to be good students. And I'm sure that all of you are good students, aren't you? To make an A honor roll or stuff like that? Huh?
Yeah.
And how about you? You sleep in class because you got your arms folded already. You sleep in, and you too. What kind of grade you make?
Fourth.
You're in the fourth grade? What kind of grade do you get?
A's
and B's. That's why you can rest like that, okay? That's good.
I do that in first grade.
You do that in first grade? Okay. Well, you got a little time, but it's about service, and you spend the 13 weeks, you get to drive a police car real fast around the track, making the tires squeal, and backing up and doing all the crazy stuff you see on TV. And then you also get to shoot the weapons. You get to shoot a shotgun, you get to shoot a pistol, and that's all important because sometimes you have to use those things in law enforcement. But they also teach you how to use your good judgment, because you don't always have to tussle with people. They teach you how to talk to people. And that's important because you're dealing with solving problems, conflict resolution. You know, people are arguing with one another, maybe mom and dad are arguing, or maybe even mom and son, or mom and daughter, or sister, brother. You have to go to people's houses and get them to calm down and to behave nicely and interact properly with one another. So it's all about service. And then, well, sometimes you have to really, your service or desire for service is really challenged. Because you may have to jump in a brake and pull somebody out of the car that had an accident. Or you may have to run in a building and get some kids out, which some of my friends have had to do. There's a fire, they have to run in there and get the people out and risk their lives. So it's a challenge. And you have to be up to that. Are you guys up to that? You think you can do that?
Uh-huh.
You don't do? Well, it's good to know.
I think that would be hard.
It would be hard. Running in a fire, yeah. Everybody in the police work is like firefighters. Policemen and firefighters run to danger while everybody else is running the opposite direction. So you do have to make a decision. Are you ready to do that? Because it's more than just a paycheck. It's about what?
Helping people.
Helping people. Service. You have to be committed. You have to definitely be committed. So you go to the academy. Get out, they give you a nice new uniform, and you got your shoes are shiny, and you jump in the patrol car. And usually the first person is, you start off as a patrolman.
What if you can get a cop or a motorcycle?
Well, that comes later. They're not going to give you a motorcycle through the door. Okay? You have to wait on that. So usually we end up in a patrolman. That's usually the officers you see riding around in the car, aggravating your mom and dad because they're pulling them over for speeding or stopping them from running a stop sign that they swear they didn't run. So they write tickets, they go to respond to bank robberies and stuff like that. And then there's also the investment banking division, which a lot of people enjoy doing. Everybody wants to wear the nice suit or the or just regular clothes and be detectives, huh? Anybody watch detective shows like CSI and things like that? Probably moms and dads watch that. Now you get to be narcotics investigators, which you investigate drug crimes, which is important. It's awesome. It's pretty dangerous because sometimes we have to sell the bad guys some drugs, and then when they get down the street, then we arrest them. So you can be a detective in homicide or narcotics or juvenile detectives who work with kids and deal with their issues like running away, truancy, delinquent behavior like picking up other kids or breaking the neighbor's windows. And also we do other things like the motorcycles. You got guys that ride motorcycles, and that's pretty difficult. So they have about a 2-week class where they have to know how to ride that motorcycle for hours and hours and turn all kind of crazy ways that I wouldn't even know how to do. But we got about 5 guys that ride motorcycles here in police department. Yeah. So, are there any questions? We'll take a moment for questions. You want to say something about it?
You remember the time you told me about the car, the disguise cars?
The undercover cars? Okay, yeah, we got undercover cars. So police aren't always in the blue and white cars. Sometimes we drive trucks. Sometimes we drive little bitty, raggedy cars so that we can get close to the criminals and jump out and arrest them. But the important thing, though, with law enforcement, as I said, is about service. The policemen aren't bad guys. You know, a lot of times kids are like, that's the police. We don't tell them nothing. But we're here to help you. So if you don't tell us anything, then we can't help you. And what continues? Bad things continue. You have dope dealers in your neighborhood. You're going to have dope dealers in your neighborhood because you didn't tell anyone. So you have to notify the police and not be afraid. If somebody's breaking in houses, tell your parents so that they can call the police. And let them know what's going on so we can have a safe community. And that's what servants do. Servants help. And the police department wants to be here to help people, put the bad guys in jail so that we can go outside and play without worrying about people snatching us or shooting at us or breaking in our houses. And if we work together, then things would be better. And if you guys join the police department when you get older, and we can continue that, because right now you got a foundation being laid because you're coming to a religious-based program learning about helping your community and about a sense of a Christian service. If you don't have any more questions, then I'm going to have a seat and watch the rest of the program. Thank you.